Okay, children, today we will start with a revision of EVS class. Okay, EVS is the subject which is being included in your class 6th also. Show thumbs up. Everybody have learned about EVS in class 6th? Yes or no? Very good. You have already studied from the book Environmental Education. The book is there in your class 6. Class 6, you have this book. Okay? And this. So, you will do with the revision from this book. Okay? We will start with the revision of class 6 for class 7th. Okay, children, so we will study about environmental education or what is EVS all about. So this book contains about various chapters, and we will start with the, or we will just start with the revision of the class 6. Okay, children, for today. So, first, everybody please understand what is environmental study. Okay? Now, those children who are attending the class, please log in with your name, class, and section. Everybody, please log in with your name, class, and section for your attendance. Everybody, keep your cameras on. Pranav, Manan, everybody keep your cameras on. Pranav, Naman Malik, keep your cameras on. Otherwise, I will remove it from the class. Cameras on. Very good. Who is this Naman Malik? Please keep your cameras on. And sit straight, everybody. Okay. Now, what is EVS or environmental study? Environmental study is the study of our surroundings. Environmental study is the study of our surroundings. Okay. Show me thumbs up if I'm audible. Show thumbs up. Very good. Very good class. Very attentive. Very nice. Our environment means our surroundings. What is my environment? My environment is the class. My environment is the board. My environment are the fans. This is my environment. And what is your environment? What is your environment? Your room is your environment. Say yes. Your room is your environment. Say yes. Show me thumbs up, everybody. Your room is the environment or your surroundings. Okay. So, our surroundings keep on changing. When you go to the playground, your environment changes. When you go to your kitchen, your environment changes. When you go to school, your environment changes. So, whatever is surround us, whatever is around us is called as environment. Okay? Is that very clear? Whatever surround us is called as environment. Clear? Now, there are various things which are found in our environment. Some are living things, some are non-living. Can anybody tell me fan? Living thing, non-living thing? Living thing, thumbs up. Living thing, thumbs up. No. Fan is a non-living. Understood? Fan is a non-living. What is living thing around you? Plants. Show me thumbs up. Okay. Plants are living things. In when you go to the playground, the plants are living things. Understood? Very good. Very nice. So when we talk about environment, we actually speaking about our surroundings, and it is different from place to place. Our environment keeps on changing when we move from place to place. Understood? So environment can be categorized into natural and social environment. Okay, so we divide environment into two parts. First is natural environment. First is natural environment, and second is social environment. Second is social environment. Okay, now what is natural environment? Natural environment consists of living things and non-living. So natural environment can be divided. First we will talk about natural. Okay, so natural environment can be divided into living, non-living. Can you see everybody? Show me thumbs up. Can you see the board? Very good. So natural environment can be divided into living thing and non-living. Okay? Living thing and non-living. So abiotic or non-living. So first we will talk about non-living. First, we will learn about non-living. Okay, so we will take first is soil. We will today study about non-living thing soil. First is soil. First, soil is a living thing or non-living thing? Soil is a non-living. Thumbs up. Soil is a non-living thing. Very good. Okay. Now, soil is the uppermost layer of the earth crust. Everybody knows this. Can you see soil? Yes. Nod your head. Can you see soil? Yes. So, soil we can see, and it is the topmost layer of the earth crust. And in which the plants grow. Plants grow. Can plants grow without soil? No. Plants need soil to grow. Okay? So, now, and soil is a home for small animals. Find small insects, some earthworms in the soil. Okay? So, all these things are found in soil. And soil is a non-living thing. Clear, children? Non-living thing, soil. Now, next is air and wind. Air and wind. What is wind? Wind means the, you can see when the air moves. When the air moves from one place to another. Okay? This moving of the air is called as wind. When the air is around us, we found air around us. Okay, when this air moves from one place to another, it is called as wind. Understood? So we found air which is all around us, and when this air moves, we called it as wind. Understood this thing? So this, we have around us with the air, we have atmosphere. Everybody who knows about atmosphere, thumbs up. Please show thumbs up. Anybody, everybody who knows about atmosphere. Very good. All the children know about atmosphere. Okay. So, atmosphere is around us. and this atmosphere contains various gases, various different air or various different types of gases are found in our atmosphere. Okay, so and a very important thing we found in this atmosphere is oxygen. Do living things need oxygen? Say yes or no. Do living things need oxygen? Yes, living things need oxygen. From where we found this oxygen? We found this oxygen in air. Found this oxygen in atmosphere. Okay? And there are this. Have you heard about monsoon winds? Monsoon winds are those winds which bring rainfall. Yes, we have rainy season, and this rainy season is because of the movement of the wind. Okay, so when the air moves, they bring moisture and they bring rainfall all over the country. The next is water, humidity, and rain. Okay, what is water? Everybody knows what is water. Everybody drinks water. Is water important for us? Yes, water is important for us. Can we survive without water? Can we survive without water? Can we survive? No, we cannot survive without water. So water is also very essential for the living organisms. All the living things need water to live. They need water to grow. And not even human beings. The animals and plants also need water. Okay? So, and this water comes us in form of rainfall. When the rainfall is there, this rainfall comes and we get fresh water. When we get this fresh water, due to the rainfall, it collects in various tanks, in various ponds, in various types of rivers and oceans. So all this water is collected and this water is being used by human beings, plants and animals also. Okay, and we have rainfall, and this rainfall is a most important factor for fresh water. The best form of fresh water, we can get it from rainfall. This rainwater should not be wasted. We should collect this rainwater and can be used in our dryer, or you can see when there is no rainfall. So fresh water source is rainfall. Next is temperature. Can you feel hot or cold? Nowadays it is hot. Say thumbs up. Everybody is feeling hot? Yes. Why we are feeling hot? Due to temperature. When temperature is high, you feel hot. When temperature is low, you feel cold. So temperature also changes from place to place. Understood? Temperature also keep on changing from place to place. This temperature is also the part of our environment. Some places are very cold, some places are very hot. So our environment consists of temperature also. Light. Can you see the sun shining? The sun is a very important source of energy and light. When you go out, you don't need a light. Why you don't need a light? Because this light is being given to us by sun. So, and this light is required by us. Light is used by us, not only by the human beings, but also by the plants and animals to make food. Okay, so in desert we found a lot of light and heat due to environment, and in colder areas the light is less and it is cold because sun is shining for a short duration of time. So important source of heat and light is sun. Okay, this is about living, non-living. Now we will talk about living. The next important thing we will talk about today is living. Okay. Next important thing we will talk about is living. Living thing, microorganism. Can you see small insects in the soil, etc.? So these small insects are living organisms. Okay. Microorganisms which are so tiny that cannot be seen from our eyes. There are small bacteria which cannot be seen from our eyes, but it is present in our environment. Okay, so there are various plants and animals. They are all living things. Human beings, all living things. Okay, first herbivorous. Herbivorous are the plant. They eat plants only like deer and goat. We can categorize the living beings into herbivorous. Those animals which eat only grass, only plants, they are called as herbivorous animals. Okay, carnivorous. Everybody knows about carnivorous. Is lion and tiger a carnivorous or herbivorous? Say thumbs up about carnivorous. Lions, etc. are carnivorous. Say thumbs up. Very good, children. Please be active. Yes. So those animals which eat flesh of other animals are called as carnivorous. Omnivorous. The next important thing is omnivorous. They eat both plants and animals. Okay, like men. Men eat both plants as well as flesh. So we are omnivorous. We are living thing. Okay, we are living thing. And decomposers. Decomposers are those animals which destroys the dead bodies of plants and animals. They decompose it. They destroy it. Okay, so they are also living organisms. Okay, they are also living organisms. So this ends with the class for today. I'll repeat once again. Today we will study about the revision of environmental education, and the chapter we will start is the division of environmental studies into natural environment and social environment. Social we will do in the next class. Natural environment divided into two, living and non-living. We have already studied about living and non-living. And in the next class, we will study about the social environment. Okay, children, please study hard, be on time, and see, there are two children who have come now. So, children, be on time and give your attendance, and please write down your name with your class and section. Okay, study, and we will make one copy for environmental education also. So when you are making a copy, please make one copy, separate copy for EBS. Okay, when we will start with a fresh chapter, you have to write down the question and answer. Okay, okay, children, I'm switching off the video and audio and taking the attendance. Everybody, don't leave the class. Okay, I'm taking it, the screenshot. Please don't leave the class. Okay, children, now please study whatever is being taught in all the classes and please stay safe and study hard. Okay, bye. Thank you.